We begin with quite a fish tale tonight. A Honolulu man has extra reason to be very thankful this holiday season after a bizarre run-in with a giant marlin.
Russell Ching and a couple of buddies were fishing off windward Oahu when they hooked the 500-pound fish.
He says they fought it for nearly 2 hours, but that was only the beginning of yet another more harrowing ordeal. And a warning, we blurred some of the images, but they're still graphic. It's a story you'll see only on 2. After the lengthy and exhausting battle, Russell Ching and his buddies were celebrating the catch. The fish was dead, but the fight was far from over.
As we drug it in, once, you know, all that weight got over the side, it just slid right in, and I was kind of in a bad position, and it went through my leg. Yeah. Well, it went in point first, this way.
Oh.
When it first went in, I mean, I couldn't believe how easy it went into my leg. I mean, it was just like a hot knife through butter.
Ching says the spear pinned him to the side of the boat and that he was trapped under the weight of the fish, which was more than 500 pounds.
After that, it felt like first the shock set in, and it felt like someone had kicked me in the shin, and that's how it felt the whole time. I was always concerned about marlins when they were alive. But this one was dead, and just the shift in weight, you know, pushed it right into my leg, which, I mean, I couldn't believe it, you know.
Although he had the spear tip in his leg, luck would be on his side. The tip sliced cleanly through his leg, missing all major arteries. But they were still more than 25 miles, about 2 hours from shore. His initial fear was bleeding out.
I was afraid of that. I kept asking my friend if it was bleeding, but he said it wasn't. So, yeah, I wasn't too concerned about that. Plus, the bill kind of plugged it up.
Despite his harrowing ordeal, Ching says he plans on being out there on the water, hopefully sometime soon. But before that, two questions just needed to be asked.
What did you do with the fish? What are you going to do with the tip?
So, the tip, I'll probably, I don't know, maybe mount it or something. That's a good story to tell people. Yeah. Probably keep it for maybe home defense or something.
And the fish?
And the fish, my buddy sold it. So I didn't get a chance to, you know, take a photo or anything like that.
No photos, not a single bite. Now, if you want to see more of the unedited images of what happened, we posted the raw video on our website. Ching says the frightening ordeal was a good reminder to always respect not only the ocean, but what you're catching, and that he knows the outcome could have been much worse. And case in point, you may recall this. A freak accident last May, a swordfish killed 47-year-old Randy Lannis of Kailua Kona. He was apparently watching, saw the fish in Honokohau Harbor, jumped into the water, and then speared it. But the swordfish began thrashing and then impaled him with its 3-foot-long bill. Lannis later died at a local hospital.